ça me fait plaisir d'endosser Christine Elliott pour la raison même, parce que c'est notre candidate du Parti progressiste conservateur, notre candidate d'inclusion. C'est celle qui nous apporte les valeurs du centre, où l'Ontario se situe. Et Christine, définitivement, est notre meilleure candidate pour nous rejoindre à la prochaine élection, qu'elle devienne l'Ontario PC, devient le gouvernement et qu'on puisse remettre l'Ontario sur la bonne voie. Merci.
On vient d'entendre Martin Forget. C'est un ancien candidat progressiste conservateur dans Ottawa-Vanier. M. Forget vient d'ajouter son nom à la liste déjà longue d'appui à Christine Elliott, qui est la favorite dans la course à la chefferie du parti d'opposition à Queen's Park. Mais qui est Christine Elliott? Qu'est-ce qui la motive à vouloir diriger le Parti progressiste conservateur? Et surtout, qu'est-ce qui la distingue de ses prédécesseurs et de ses concurrents? Eh bien, voici l'entrevue que Mme Elliott nous a accordée un peu plus tôt cette semaine. Christine Elliott, good to have you on the show.
Great to be here, François Pierre. Thank you.
Tell me, what makes you the best candidate to run the PC party and maybe eventually become Premier of Ontario?
Well, I think right now it's the experience that I have. I'm really worried about the state of Ontario's economy. We're in a very deep economic hole, and it's going to take a lot of work to get us out of it. And I have had extensive experience outside of public life. I practiced law for about 25 years before I became an elected MPP. And I also worked with one of Canada's largest banks on their international audit team. I think that's important both for the leader of our party, but as well for the Premier of Ontario to understand that big picture and what we need to do economically to start turning Ontario around.
It's not the first time that you run for the job. What have you learned from previous experiences?
Well, lots of things. First of all, what you need to do in order to create that winning team. And it is important to connect with people across the province. This is a much longer leadership race than it was in 2009. In 2009, the whole thing was said and done within 3 months. Now we're going into the eighth month since I declared my intention to run for leader. And I know that people feel that it's a big, important decision to make. And so I really want to visit all parts of Ontario to make sure that I can connect with people and speak to them about my vision for both for our party as well as for our province.
You've talked a lot about broadening the base, you know, the big blue tent. You've been talking a lot about that. How do you make that happen?
Well, I think we do need to reach out and build that winning coalition. I think it doesn't help to talk about whether we need a red Tory leader or blue Tory leader or a social conservative leader. We're all progressive conservatives, and we need to make sure that we band together and we reach out to groups of people that haven't traditionally been supportive of us, which to me is twofold. One is being fiscally conservative and fiscally responsible. We need to live within our means, not spend money that we don't have, and to spend the money that we do have on priorities. And to me, the priorities are being fiscally responsible so we can be socially compassionate, so that we can help our most vulnerable citizens who aren't able to help themselves. And that's a message that I think people haven't heard from us recently as progressive conservatives. And it is a message that's gaining resonance across the province as I've been traveling, that's what people expect their government to do. And that's what I would certainly want to provide as both leader of our party and as premier of the province.
One of the groups that has not been keen on voting for the Ontario PC in the past has been the Francophones, especially since the Montfort Hospital saga in the late 1990s. How are you going to rebuild bridges with the minority?
Well, I think the Francophone communities are very, very important to Ontario, part of our legacy, part of our history, an important part of our economy and our culture. So it is important for us to reach out. I understand that there have been some decisions made in the past that didn't really sit well with the Heritage Francophone community particularly. And we need to fix that, so that we really need to make sure that we have those services, all health and educational services, available for everyone in Ontario. And the Francophone communities need to be able to receive those services in their own language. It's vitally important for everyone's health and well-being.
You were second in command over the last couple of years in the party, while the party was losing touch with a lot of its base and a lot of the voters of Ontario. How can you be an important part of the recent past of your party and yet be the voice of the change?
Well, I think that what happened the last time around was that decisions were being made by a small group of people that didn't include all of us as caucus members. And that there were people that made some significant policy decisions that I'm sure don't knock on doors, because if they did, they would know that some of the policies that we came forward with were going to be toxic to us. So that's why it's important to me to change that, to make sure that we involve our caucus members in all decisions, but we all have to be part of the team. And I think that has been missing for the last several years. That's what I want to build again to make sure that we're going to be successful in the next election campaign in 2018.
Christine Elliott, thank you.
Merci, François-Pierre. Pleasure. Thank you.